I'm really going to reiterate quite a few things which Jawahar has mentioned. We have been talking about this home isolation of either the suspect cases or of the mild, very, very mild symptomatic. I know, Jawahar, you're mentioning these guidelines they can follow, but hopefully you all will look into it a little more in detail before they are sort of implemented. But in any case, it's a very good guideline which has come, and we will use that as we go along. So we'll have a more detailed discussion once I think we have an internal discussion again, and if once I'm able to talk to you, Jawahar, on it. So that's one thing. The second thing on, again, two things which Jawahar has mentioned and which I would like to highlight, because every day when we have the Chief Minister's meeting, there are two points on which he definitely asks us, and on those two we are a little on the weak ground. One is the testing of all those people who were found symptomatic during the fever surveillance, as we call it, syndromic surveillance or fever surveillance, the three rounds which you all went house to house. So that number was some 32,000 and odd. Even till today, we are telling the Honorable CM that only 10,000 are tested. So I'm not sure what figure is being shown in that Bhaskar's MIS. Last time you all told us that some provision is not there in the app for including those tests which are done.
Why is it not there?
Are you able to hear? Hello. Can you hear now? Kadapa, can you hear me? There are two points I want to bring to your notice, which the Honorable Chief Minister every day in the meeting is asking us. One is to complete the testing of those 32,000 whom we had listed as part of our house-to-house survey in the three phases. Most of you mentioned that there was no provision in that app for recording it. And Bhaskar had said he will rectify, and I'm sure he has. But even then, Jawahar had told all of you to set it as Excel sheets. The second thing which CM does review is the telemedicine and the disbursement of the medicines wherever the advice has been given by the medical officers. I request you all to do a video conference of the medical officers of the PHCs and the UHCs to make sure that through the telemedicine, whoever has been prescribed the medicine, you actually deliver it also. Telemedicine is going to be a very powerful tool for you to reduce OPs at your subcenters and at the PHCs, and especially so in the times of COVID-19. So telemedicine will help you to handle the OPs of COVID-19 also and the non-COVID-19. We have not had time to discuss, at least at my level, because we have so many other items to discuss. But it doesn't mean that it doesn't have to be handled as a priority. Please put one vertical on the job for telemedicine. It's really going to be very, very important that you have this telemedicine system. It will be of great use in this next 1 or 2 years when we have to learn to live with COVID-19. The second thing which we have to do is to ensure the use of Arogya Setu. Without that also, we will have a problem after the lockdown. See, you need to have the telemedicine in position, you need to have the Arogya Setu also into position. We are issuing a GO in which we are just telling that everybody has to work for encouraging the downloading of the app. Even this home isolation guideline, the person cannot undergo home isolation if he has not downloaded the Arogya Setu. So we are also saying employees cannot come to the secretariat if they don't have the Arogya Setu app. So on and so forth. It is for everybody's need. Okay, so I want you to take up, once this GO is also issued, please take a drive to see that the Arogya Setu is downloaded by everybody. Now these are the two things, the surveillance testing and the telemedicine, which Honorable CM reviews almost on a daily basis, and then he is feeling that we are not giving the adequate attention. Today actually I would like to, if it's okay with Jawahar, I would like to listen to 3-4 districts on the kind of containment they are doing. Because post May 3rd, I think your work is going to be a lot to do with the containment areas. So we should have perfected all the best practices of the containment strategy, and we should be able to do the containment in places as and where they come. So today maybe we could listen to one or two joint collectors. I have been listening to collectors also, and at some stage I also try and listen to the joint collectors. So maybe we could ask one or two of them to respond. If they are there, if they're not there, then we'll ask the collectors to respond only.
Joint chart is there, ma'am. I see joint chart.
Sir, am I audible, sir, now?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sir, as far as Guntur district is concerned, we have got two large outbreaks, sir. More than 15 cases recorded. One is Guntur urban and now the Nasrapet urban, sir. So, Guntur urban, we are getting cases day by day out. So, it has come down, sir. It was started with some 20, 25 days. Now it has come to 4 to 5 a day, sir. And all the cases are confined to the containment zones in Guntur, sir. But now the new area, new chapter is the Nasrapet, sir. Nasrapet also we got 3 important areas, in which one area constitutes for about 90% of the total positive cases coming day by day, sir. Which is in Varavata, that's a red zone in Nasrapet, where the demography is around 400 households having some 3,000 population, sir. So every segment of this particular Varavata has been now mapped. And the seriousness in the seriousness at the ground level field offices were also instilled yesterday by the visit of the district collector and the special officer, sir, Rajshekhar sir. And we had a very comprehensive meeting as to what are the important aspects of containments and the surveillance which we have to take care of. And that orientation with the help of our state advisor, Dr. Kamal Raj, was also very helpful, sir. And the insights have been shared to the field level ANMs, sir. Now, sub-collector is the in-charge of the entire containment zone in Nasrapet. We created 7 verticals, what are created in the districts, and the responsible officers were also posted to those verticals, sir. Now, we have got some good view about the Nasrapet, sir. So, our important area is in Varavakatta, where...
We have planned for vigorous testing in our containment zones, ma'am. The way which we are going ahead with maintaining the containment is, we have put the check posts around the containment areas where the police, health and municipal teams are placed, no? So that these people will not come out of the containment area. And we are sending the mobile refrigerators and also mobile supermarkets we are sending. And we are also taking online now. We are giving online delivery of the essential commodities now. And recently, since past 3 days, they have started visible policing also there, because these are slum areas, ma'am, like Krishnananka, Vidus Nagar and Karnik Nagar, where people, we thought that only that, that people are moving within the containment zone, though they are not coming outside. So to create the fear within the containment zones also, they have started visible policing with all the vehicles and also police marching there. And the collector sir and CK sir themselves have gone there so that the people